Good morning, students. Welcome to the virtual classrooms. We are doing it chapter number 11. We did it as an alcohols and phenols. Today we will be studying the preparation properties of ethers. We know it. Ether means RO, R dash. They can be of two types, simple as well as mixed ethers. We will study both of them, how to prepare simple ethers and mixed ethers. Now, for that case, the first method that is there, through which we are always going to produce simple ethers. By this method, we always get it as simple ethers, right? Now, during this process, what we are doing it is, we are taking it as an alcohol. Let's take it as a specific alcohol in place of generalized, as per given in our textbook. We are taking it as a specific alcohol, ethanol, right? Now, when we take it as an ethanol and react it in presence of concentrated H2SO4. Now, when you are reacting it with concentrated H2SO4, we are there to be carefully carried out the reaction, because by changing the temperature, our product will be changed. If you change the temperature, right? See, I wrote it as 443. There is a minor difference of 30 degrees Celsius temperature. Many times students are asking it, sir, if temperatures are not specified, what will be the problem? If small change in the temperature is there, if in place of 25, I'm writing 27 degrees Celsius, what is an effect? See, this is one of the reaction which is helping us to understand that, why the temperatures are specific. Here, reactant is same, reagent is same, only the differences of temperature. During this process, if I carried out the reaction at 413, the product I am going to get it is CH3CH2CH2CH3. Why? In the 443 Kelvin temperature, the product we will be getting it is a CH2 double bond CH2. That means during both the reaction, I am going to give out the byproduct of H2 only. But at 413, two different molecules combine together to give out the H2O. Over here, we get it as an H2O, as in beta elimination, right? Particularly, during this reaction, if I keep on adding alcohol, I'm going to get as an ether continuously. So this particular process is known as continuous etherification process, right? Now let's see the mechanism. This is your third mechanism of the chapter, right? We already know it, that we want to go it for the different mechanisms. Now this mechanism, what is the mechanism of this reaction? We are going it for the step one. We are carrying out the reaction as concentrated H2SO4. So that means I'm going to get it as an H plus CH3 CH2 OH. I'm going to react it with H plus. That means this particular reaction is known as protonation. In all the steps we are doing it the same conditions. All the mechanisms till now we have studied it. We are doing it, first step is a protonation. Right. Now during this case, what will happen? These H plus will attack onto the electrophile. Electron present as on the oxygen, and it gets converted into COH as an oxygen with a positive ion. Now in this step 2, there is a reaction of oxygen. Reaction of alcohol on, right? Now we know it, that always our second step is somewhat different. We are going to get it here, another molecule of alcohol. See, we wrote it as two molecules of alcohol. So another molecule of alcohol it's going to react with CH3, CH2, O, H, H. So at that time, what will happen? This component is going to dissociate itself from it, and this lone pair will attack onto the this carbon will attack onto the lone pair of the oxygen. So you are going to get it as CH3, CH2, O, H, CH2, CH3, and this oxygen will become positively charged because water is given out. This is your H on this oxygen, COH. Now step 3, that is our fixed for all the mechanism, deprotonation. That means this time I'm going to remove H plus. So how we are going to get it? This component, CH3, CH2, O, H, CH2, CH3 will decompose itself and gets converted into O, CH2, CH3, and H plus is given. That is the deprotonation, right? So protonation, reaction of alcohol, and then deprotonation. By this method, we are always getting it as a simple ether because two molecules of the same components are used for the reaction. So this particular method is used for preparation of simple ethers. Now, in place of simple ethers, suppose if I want it as a mixed ethers, then what to do? Then the second preparation that we will be doing it, that is preparation for mixed ethers. Now, mixed ethers means we know it that ROR dash, where R is not equals to R dash. We termed it as a mixed ether. Right? So now let's see what happens or which method we are going to use it. This method is known as Williamson synthesis, particularly for the preparation of mixed ethers. What happens in this reaction? We take it as an ROH. Actually, we know it that we reacted with Na. It gets converted into RONA. This RONA is reacted with RX, R dash X. It gets converted into ROR dash. This is the particular generalized reaction. Now, during this case, if I take this R as primary, secondary, or tertiary, reaction proceeds very easily, right? It is possible for this component to go for the reaction as if it is primary, secondary, or tertiary alcohols. Alkoxides, right? That means if I take it as the reaction CH3, CH2, ONA reacts with CH3, CH2, Cl. Okay, we want it as a mix, so we will take it as CH3Cl. Right? What we will be getting it? CH3, CH2, O, CH3. Now, in place of that, if I am taking it as a secondary alcohol, if we take it as a CH, ONA, CH3, and react it with CH3Cl. By during this process also, because it's in secondary, there won't be any problem. Reaction will proceed in the similar manner. NaCl is removed. Right? Now, in place of that, if we take it as a tertiary alkoxide and react with CH3, NaCl is removed out. We get it as the reaction to proceed very easily for preparation of ether. But in spite of this, if your halide is taking it as an, it's a primary, there won't be a problem. If Rx is tertiary, then reaction does not produce ethers. If it is a tertiary halide, that means if I go ahead for the reaction CH3CCH3CH3, and in place of ONA, if I am taking over here Cl and over here CH3ONA, then reaction won't proceed for the same, it will go for alkene formation. If it is a tertiary halide, it goes for alkene formation. So during the Williamson synthesis, this is the factor that we want to remember, that tertiary halide cannot be taken it for preparation of mixed ethers. Only you can take it as a primary or secondary halides. You can take alcohol of any of it. You can take it as a primary, secondary or tertiary. Any of it will do. But halide only primary or secondary. Right? Okay. Now these are the preparation. The same preparation we can do it for aromatic ethers also by Williamson synthesis. Preparation of aromatic ether, that is by Williamson synthesis only. If we are having it as an phenol, react it with NaOH, it gets converted into ONA. Once it gets converted into ONA, it's reacted with Rx. Again, remember, this should be primary or secondary only. You can't take it tertiary, right? Because it's an halide. This compound will get OR. So it gets converted into ether, right? So this reaction is also specifically used for preparing mixed aromatic ethers, right? Okay, these are the preparations that we saw it, either by simple, if I want to prepare it by the continuous etherification, and if I want to prepare the mix, I will go it by Williamson synthesis, right? Okay, the next point of the ether that we want to study it is a physical properties. Now when we are discussing about the physical property, then our first point that we want to discuss, that is specifically ethers are having lower boiling point than that of the alcohols. Ethers have lower boiling point than corresponding alcohols. Now what is the reason for this? Why ethers are having lower boiling point than their alcohols? The reason is alcohols can form H bonds, while ether cannot form H bond. If we see it in the form of ROH, this can produce H bonds. But when we are having it as an ether, though it's having it, no hydrogen. And therefore, it can't produce hydrogen bond. And as a result, the boiling point of ethers are lower than that of the alcohols. That is the one specific property, right? Second thing, ethers are insoluble in water. The second we want to remember is ethers are insoluble in water. Again, answer is one and the same. as they cannot produce H bond.
The reason we will be writing for it is
as they cannot form H bonds. Ethers are insoluble in water, right? So that is the physical properties of ether, right? The next one we are having, it is a chemical properties of the ether. Now when we are talking about chemical properties of ether, the first one we are having it, the reaction with HI. Now this particular reaction has a certain characteristic, that is, if I am taking it as an ROR dash and I am reacting with HI, that means I did not specify that I am taking it as an more amount of HI, it's a restricted, I am taking it as in one mole. So at that time what happens, the product I am going to get, it is ROH plus R dash I. Now during this case what happens, you can say that the bond has been broken out, one is getting it as an H, another one is getting it as an I. Now which component is it necessary that every time R dash will be getting it as an I? No. Now it depends on the number of the carbon atoms that are present in R or R dash. The chain which has less number of carbon atoms contains oxygen, which forms alcohol. A small chain will contain oxygen, right? So that means if I am having it as in CH3O CH3, then for this component there won't be any problem because both of them are having same number of carbons. They won't have any problem because both of them are having same number of carbons. But in place of that, if I am having it as a CH3O CH2 CH3, and if I am reacting with HI, it gets converted into CH3OH plus CH3CH2I, right? The smaller one got it as an oxygen, the bigger chain got it as converted into halide. But in place of that, if this reaction is carried out with excess of HI, then at that time what will happen? This component will have Ri, R dash I plus H2. In both the cases, we are going to get it as an halides. That means if I am having it as an a same number of carbon chain with excess of HI, then in that case I am going to get it as 2 moles of CH3I plus H2O. But if I am having it as an mixed ethers and we are reacting it with excess of HI, then it gets converted into CH3I C2H5I plus H2O. That means both of them are going to be separated out, right? Okay, now these were for the simple or mixed aliphatic ethers. Now a small change for this one, if I am having it, we wrote it for aliphatic, right? Now in place of that, for aromatic ethers, if I am having it as an OCH3, then as per this rule, what should happen? I should get methanol. But no, here when I will be reacting with HI, we get it as OH and CH3I, right? The reason is
due to resonance, the OH, the oxygen carbon bond being carbon of benzene, right? Because both the cases we are having carbon, so we will specify that OC bond of benzene becomes being stronger. It does not dissociate, and therefore we get it as phenol plus methyl iodide. So that is because of the aromatic. In the aliphatic we got it as smaller with oxygen. Oxygen will go with a smaller chain, but here for the aromatic oxygen will go to the aromatic component, right? So that is for the cleavage of that compound, right? Okay, next one, we are having it as an electrophilic substitution reaction. Next one we are having, it is a electrophilic substitution reaction. Now when we are talking about the electrophilic substitution reaction, means we are having it of OCH3 group. Electrophilic means we will be going it for nitration, sulfonation, chlorination, bromination and alkylation, acylation. So first of all we will go it for nitration. For nitration we will be using it as a concentrated HNO3 plus concentrated H2SO4. Now when we are going for concentrated HNO3 and H2SO4, what will happen? OCH3, it's an ortho para directing, so we get it as ortho plus para product. We get it as ortho and para because OCH3, it's an ortho para directing group. Similarly, if we go it for sulfonation by using concentrated H2SO4, the product you are going to get, it is a ortho plus para for halogenation. X2, where X can be ClBr in presence of FeCl3, we get it as OCS3X plus on the ortho para position. Similarly, if we go it for alkylation, RX in presence of anhydrous AlCl3, we get it as OCS3R. We get it as an ortho position, the alkyl group, right, plus onto the para position. Same way if we go it for acylation, the next term, OCS3, RCOCl or RCO twice O, either acid chloride or anhydride, either of the component can be taken. In presence of anhydrous AlCl3, the reaction we are going to get, it is a OCS3 COR plus OCS3 COR, ortho plus para, right? So these are the reactions that we are going to get it by electrophilic substitution. Chlorination, bromination, that has generally taken it as an halogenation. Alkylation, acylation are specifically known as Friedel-Crafts alkylation acylations, right? Okay, that's all what we are having it for this chapter, right? This was for the ethers which was left out, right? Now from next lecture we will be starting with the next organic chapter of aldehyde, ketone and carboxylic acid. Right? So in next lecture we will discuss about chapter number 12. Thank you.